Okay, fresh from a top 8 spot at Euros last month. Rafael, you ended up top 16 here at Wises Rimini with Demise Cosmo, right?
Demise Cosmo with Artifacts.
Yes. One of the few. I didn't see any Cosmo, not a lot.
My team played Pendulum mostly, and was the plan I would play that as well.
Right.
But my friend Tamas needed his cards, I bought some stuff, so I borrowed him my cards. And I want, so I need to play another deck, and I wanted to play either Demise or Cosmo or Burning Abyss.
Right.
But I didn't feel comfortable playing the mirror, Burning Abyss mirror, because of the cherries. So I chose Demise.
Cosmo. Easy. Okay. Yeah. Let's see the list.
Can I say?
Yeah. Definitely. Because, definitely.
I want to thank Complexity Card Gaming for adopting me in this team. Like best team, amazing. I'm already learning from those guys. And we had six people in tops this event, so it's going really well for us.
Yeah, definitely.
And for me, because I'm sitting here again. Yeah. So, okay, let's
first
go.
Time new shirt.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Let's so obviously, there's nothing changed about the ships, Free Dark Destroyer, if you slip. One of this, I still see people not playing this, and it's retarded because you need the third bigger ship with Cosmojo to float down into Lady or Slip Rider, so you need to play it. It's like no option. Three of this, obviously, one Strawman's still enough. I cut down one of the farm bills, and I play the one Lady because it's enough.
Right.
For artifacts, one Moral Attack and one Scythe. Which I drew surprisingly a lot, actually. Yeah, but I chose to play this. I discussed with Joshua Hosters, obviously.
Yeah.
And we came to the conclusion that if we play this, we have like such a strong matchup against Burning Abyss, because if you go first and you drop this on them, the turn they lose is too valuable, and it gives you the perfect setup. And this is also great against Pendulum. So we chose to play this to give us the edge against Burning Abyss. This card. They didn't hit us. That's ridiculous. So it's still a viable deck after Monday. Free Town, obviously. Two of this. And two pots.
Yeah.
Two are still enough. You don't never want to have two in hand.
Yeah,
so
indeed.
You don't play free. For traps, free Sanctum. Warning. Free Strike. Free because I cut the kill strap holes and max out on strike because we expected the Pendulum would be much more popular than Monarch. Pools, still 5 pools. I might bump it up to 3 now that Dark Story gets limited, but for this event 5 was perfect. And the best trap.
Right. So 40 cards.
41!
41, okay.
Yeah, we had 40 cards and I needed to cut something because 40 is the holy number, but we really wanted to play the third Slip Rider because of the artifacts, because you can trigger them on your own turn really easily with a third one. And I'm glad I did because the third one did came up a lot. So,
post the list. What would you still play Cosmos post?
Yeah. The only thing you're losing, the teleport, it doesn't really matter. Two Darkstories. That's like my friend Joshua played a Peach match and he had to discard two Darkstories with the mice.
Right.
And he said, he told me like playing with one more Darkstory is hard. But we thought about and things you could do. You could try Escape from the Dark Dimension. So trap card summons a banished monster that's dark.
Exactly.
So we could look into that because they didn't hit this.
Yeah, indeed.
So you can still open Tinken and the Mice and have such advantage.
Yeah, indeed.
And they didn't hit Cosmojo, which is like insane. So I would say this is very, very viable.
Mm-hmm.
Also, because I lost in top 16 against Extra Deck Monarch,
which
is your hardest matchup. Like Pendulum is almost auto win. Burning Abyss is quite good if you know how to grind them out, and like normal Cosmo is like nothing. So actually, like Monarch is the only problem, and actually Monarch is hit really, really hard.
Dead.
So your worst matchup is gone, probably.
Uh-huh.
So what else is going to be new? Like Blue Eyes is a pretty good matchup for this deck.
Uh-huh.
Like what are you going to do against Dark Destroyer? So I would say this deck is very, very much viable for the next format.
Okay. Thank you.
Extra deck is almost irrelevant, but I got two affinities because you make affinity like sometimes, and I want to have a second. If you get a call, call this. Pleiades. I made this quite a lot because it's so reactive. Like I made it when I knew they have Ever, and so when you go Ever, you bounce the one monster they have, something like that. Like made this a lot. Never made any of these. And these are here for the cherries.
Right. Okay.
So side deck. When I go second against Burning Abyss, I want to have the cherries. Like I said, we were really expecting the cherries. Burning Abyss. So we went with cherries if you go second, even though it conflicts with the mice. But that's why you cannot side deal when you go first. And it worked out really well. Interested, never sided this, didn't like it at all, but I needed something against back row.
True.
I was thinking about double cyclone, but like I said, this was a really last minute decision, so I didn't have them with me. That's also why there's no Barbaroid in the extra deck, which should play because monarchs want to curse this.
Yeah, indeed.
So you should definitely play it. It's just I thought we decided to play this like Friday night, so I didn't have all this card with me, but I didn't like this. This obviously. Stupid card, but yeah, it's really good. Best card against monarchs, and it's becoming my favorite card because still so many people are walking into this with three or more monsters. I signed in against everything if I go second, like Pendulum, Monarchs, Burning Abyss, Mirror. It's great against
nobody expects it.
Nobody expects this, and when they've seen it, they're always afraid of it.
Yeah,
and you can bluff this card so good. You can, if they have multiple monsters, they get like they overestimate themselves, make a mistake, and then walk into this. And this was really really good this weekend. It resolved this a lot.
Okay.
So yeah.
Any last words?
Yeah, shout out to Plexi Card Game, obviously. Shout out to Joshua Oosters, who still is the co-creator together with Fraser Smith of this deck. And I'm really happy with my performance with me being in the team, and I hope it's going to be like this
every time.
For multiple events, yes.
Okay, Rafael, thanks for the deck of fine. Congratulations to your top 16 spot here twice. It's really